video is about what is diode and how it works.
What is diode? A diode is a two-terminal electronic component that conducts in one direction. It has low resistance to the current in one direction and infinity resistance in the other side. A p-n junction diode is made out of a crystal of semiconductor, usually silicon, but germanium and gallium arsenide are also used. Impurities are added to it to create a region on one side that contains negative charge carriers, called an n-type semiconductor, and a region on the other side that contains positive charge carriers, called a p-type semiconductor, and the diode is created. When the n-type and the p-type materials are attached together, a momentary flow of electrons occur from the n-side to the p-side, resulting in a third region between the two where no charge carriers are present. This region is called the depletion region. The diode's terminals are attached to the n-type and p-type. The boundary between these two regions, called p-n junction, is where the action of the diode takes place. When a sufficiently higher electrical potential is applied to the p-side than to the n-side, it allows electrons to flow through the depletion region from the n-side to the p-side. The junction does not allow the flow of electrons in opposite directions when the potential is applied in reverse. The force between the opposite charge forms a field of forces called electric field. This electric field is a barrier to the free electrons in the n region, needs more energy to move an electron through the electric field. The potential difference of electric field across the depletion region is the amount of voltage required to move the electrons through the electric field. This potential difference is called a barrier potential.
Forward bias is in the direction of easy current flow. How to create a forward bias diode? Connect voltage force of negative side to N region and positive side to P region. The voltage source must be set higher than the barrier potential. What happens in the diode during forward bias? The free electrons in N region is pushed by negative side of bias voltage towards the P-N junction. Flow of free electrons is called electron current. Bias voltage supplies energy to free electrons in order for them to move to P region. Electrons that reaches P region will then lose energy and combine with the holes in the valence band. Electrons in the P region are then attracted towards the positive side of the bias voltage. The holes in the P region transport electrons in order for them to move through the P region. This is known as hole current. What will happen to the depletion region during forward bias? More electrons will flow to the depletion region during forward bias. Hence, the positive ions is reduced. More holes will flow into the depletion region from the other side of p-n junction. Hence, negative ions is reduced. Depletion region is narrowed because the positive and negative ions is reduced. What will happen to the barrier potential during forward bias? An energy field is created by the electric field between positive and negative ions in depletion region. This energy field is known as barrier potential. It prevents free electrons from diffusing at equilibrium state. When a bias voltage is supplied, the free electrons will then have sufficient energy to overcome the barrier potential or field.
Reverse bias is the condition that prevents current flow passing through the diode. Figure shows a DC voltage source connected across a diode in the direction to produce reverse bias, while the voltage source of bias connection are negative to the P region and positive to the N region. The current flow is negligible in most cases. The depletion region is shown much wider than in forward bias or equilibrium. An illustration of what happens when a diode is reverse bias is shown in figure. Because unlike channels extract the positive side of the bias voltage source, boost free electrons, which are majority carries in the N regions, away from the p-n junction. As the electron flow toward the positive side of the voltage source, additional positive region widens, the availability of major carriers decrease. When reverse currents, the extremely small current that exists in reverse bias after the transition current dies out is caused by the minority carriers in the N and P region that are produced by thermally generated electron hole pairs. The small number of free minority electrons in the P region are pushed toward the p-n junction by the negative bias voltage. When these electrons reach the wide depletion region, they fall down the energy hill and combine with the minority holes in the N region as well as electrons and flow towards the positive bias voltage, creating a small hole current. The conduction band in the P region is at a higher energy level than the conduction band in the N region. Therefore, the minority electrons easily pass through the depletion region because they require no additional energy. Voltage current characteristic for forward bias is that anode positive with respect to the cathode. A forward current passes through the diode and operates in the top right quadrant of its voltage current characteristic curve. Starting at the zero intersections, curve increases gradually into the forward quadrant, but the forward current and voltage are extremely small. When the forward voltage exceeds the diode's barrier potential, the forward current increases rapidly for a very small increase in voltage. When reverse bias, cathode positive with respect to the anode, the diode blocks the current except for extremely small leakage currents and operates in the lower left quadrants of voltage current characteristic curve. The diode continues to block current flow through it until the reverse voltage across the diode becomes greater than its breakdown voltage, resulting in sudden increase in reverse current producing a downwards curve. The temperature will affect the forward and reverse bias as well. When increase in temperature in forward bias, the forward current will increase as well as decreasing in barrier potential. While in reverse bias, the reverse current will increase as well. The barrier potential decreases by 2 mV for each degree increase in temperature.
There are three types of diode model, which is the ideal models, practical models, and complete model. Ideal model of diode is a simple switch. When the diode is forward bias, it acts like a closed switch, while when the diode is reverse bias, it acts like an open switch. For an ideal diode model, barrier potential, dynamic resistance, and reverse current all neglected. So we assume to have zero voltage across diode when forward bias. The forward current is determined by Ohm's law. From the ideal characteristic curve, we can know that the reverse current is equal to zero, while the reverse voltage is equal to the bias voltage. For the practical diode model, we add the barrier potentials to the ideal switch model. The dynamic resistance is neglected. From the figure, forward voltage for silicon is equal to 0.7 volt, while 0.3 volt for the germanium. The forward current is determined by applying Kirchhoff voltage law to the figure. As shown, we can determine the forward current by Ohm's law. From the circuit figure, forward bias is equivalent to closed switch in series with a small equivalent voltage source equal to the barrier potential 0.7 volt, while reverse bias is open circuit, same as ideal diode model. Barrier potential doesn't affect the reverse bias. Last but not least, the complete diode model consists of barrier potential, dynamic resistance, internal reverse resistance, and the forward voltage. Consists of barrier potentials and voltage drop across the dynamic resistance. Forward voltage and the forward currents for the complete diode model's equation is as shown. For the forward bias, it acts as closed switch in series, barrier potential, and small dynamic resistance. While for the reverse bias, it acts as open switch in parallel with the large internal reverse resistance. From the characteristic curve for the complete diode model, we can see that slope is due to the low forward resistance, while for the constant below the y-axis is because small reverse current due to the high reverse resistance.
Okay, thanks.